backpack is on, and you can see how it hangs all the way over.
So this is the poncho in a lean-to configuration. You can see there's plenty of room. Two hiking poles, four tent pegs, two for the side, two for the rear. I'm actually going to put another one on so I can pull this out, and that would give me some laying room.
So if it's just drizzling out, but not enough that you want your rain gear all the way on, but you want to make sure that your pack is covered in the event that it starts drizzling a bit more, you can use this as a pack cover. I've got four points of contact, two at the top straps and two at the lower straps. Four points of contact, two to the upper and two to the lower straps. And this is just elastic band with a button attached, and it loops through itself. This is the poncho. I found a little bag to put it in. And these are four strap ropes for hooking it up around a tree. So here's the poncho just slid on. So it's attached on the side. The closures are buttons and elastic bands. Put a little extra elastic on each one so that I can easily operate the button, putting it on and taking it off. Underneath each button, I stitched another piece of elastic band. So if I want to use this as in a tarp mode for a lean-to or a rain fly over a seat or a hammock, that I have 10 points of contact. So I have in the rear, I added two attachments right here, and I can take this piece of 550 cord, and since the poncho is a bit long when I don't have my backpack on, this will serve as a means to cinch it up off the ground in the event that I don't have a backpack on. So, thread those two through. Slide it up over my hips, gather the material, make sure your arms are nice and free, and there you have it.
Now I've got this set up as a simple bivy tent. It's 10 feet long, so you could slide your gear into the back end. So all you need to do to get in here is move your support pole and back yourself in. And once you're inside, reset your pole. There you go. Plenty of room for one person. You can put your gear at the other end. Hi, dog. Put your gear in at the other end, and you'll be all set. Go get it. You can bring your dog along and play.
And one of the nice features of poncho is there's a lot of different ways to configure it for wearing depending on the weather conditions. So this is just taking the edges and rolling those edges up. So if the weather turns on you while you're hiking, just unroll the edges and you're back to full poncho mode. One of the things I noticed was while I had my backpack on that the sleeve area pulls up and leaves my arms exposed. And so I resolved that by attaching another piece of material and my arm fits right into it. You don't have to take it off to get it to fit on. A little spot for your thumb to come through. A lot of extra material here, so if it's raining and cold you can still have use of your hand, or if you want, you can pull it out and you can cup it down. And of course, there's one on each side. So,
hey, here's another pretty simple configuration. So the far corner is tagged down. Top is tagged down with the pole. That piece of cord, 20 feet long, that I use for the belt is connected to here, the far corner with a hiking pole, and one additional corner or edge piece. Since I've got 10 tag outs on each side, it gives me the opportunity to tag it out pretty much wherever I want.
For hammock mode, I have each corner attached with a piece of 550 cord. I three times wrapped the material around the 550 cord, and then I whip attached it so it's nice and tight.
Well, this here is an A-frame configuration. So it's got about 7 feet of room in it, and about 3.5 feet wide. You put the down angle on the windward rain side of it, and plenty of room. Plenty of room for yourself in a bag. If you want to sit up in the morning, now you're going to be right next to the pole, but that'll work.
Hey, this is Dave. So we're going to go ahead and test out this hammock. This is the poncho in hammock mode. Let's go ahead and give it a shot. Go. So this is hammock mode, and it works great.